Good day, this is Jim Pytel from Columbia Gorge Community College. This is Digital Electronics. This lecture is entitled Additional VHDL Topics, Additional Data Types, and Operators. Okay, so we're going to reach into that grab bag of additional VHDL topics, which we may have not discussed in full, and pull out data types and operators. So data types, there are additional data types beyond standard logic and standard logic vector. The two that we're going to discuss today and make use of are the integer data type and the Boolean data type. So, a standard logic vector, if you remember right, it's really kind of just a standard logic. However, you're packaging them up in easily indexable ranges. Say, for example, I could create four standard logic signals, or I could take one 4-bit standard logic vector. And if I took a 4-bit standard logic vector and said it was 0, 1, 0, 0, what I'm really meaning is the number 4. So what an integer is, it's really kind of a shorthand notation, I guess. You know this is a digital system. You know you're going to try to represent integers in digital packets. Well, check it out. The little magic elves behind VHDL and inside that software integration utility that you're using can do the conversion for you. So an integer is a data type that once you use the integer data type, VHDL will recognize, oh, he's talking about an integer with a range from 7 to 0. I'm going to create a 3-bit standard logic vector, which in reality is 3 standard logic bits. Does that make sense? Okay. And the key there, the integer, is the range. If you're going to use the integer data type, you have to specify a range. So VHDL, the little magic elves behind VHDL, by the way, there's no magic elves, knows what the range of bits. Okay, so that's how you use the integer. You got to specify a range. Okay, so here's an example of an entity, which I'm calling blah, blah, and the port statements using integer. The signal A, it's an input. It is an integer data type with a range from 0 to 7. Same thing for B, and C is an output with an integer from a range from 0 to 15. And now think about, like, what are those little elves in VHDL going to do? They are going to look at that range and say, okay, for that range, what is the appropriate number of bits? For 0 to 7 in this particular case, they're going to assign 3 bits for A, 3 bits for B, and exam question, perhaps, what's the range? I mean, this is exam question for the first class that we've done here. It's going to be 4 bits. So it's going to assign 4 bits for an output, 3 bits for A, 3 bits for B. And now let's go ahead and go into a Boolean. Boolean, it's kind of like standard logic. However, it takes the value of true or false. And again, I'm referring to as Boolean. And by the way, an integer, positive or negative whole numbers. Another topic entirely, how VHDL assigns those bits for the integer and how to interface them with your system. Another topic entirely. But let's talk about Boolean right now. Okay, so Boolean is true or false, T or F. And Boolean's expressions are exceptionally powerful for conditional statements. We may have previously discussed one of the processes called an if statement. And the basics for an if condition, blah, 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 then expression. And that condition is looking for, potentially, a Boolean true. And that's exactly, it's evaluating it. And now, for you to understand kind of the Boolean, I actually need to actually introduce some of the newer operators. Okay, so these newer operators, we have been limiting ourselves to nots, ands, ors, nans, nors, exclusive ors, exclusive nors. But in reality, there are a bunch of other operators out there. The most powerful of them are these arithmetic operators. Okay, if I've got the number A, which is an integer, and the number B, which is an integer, and the output C, which is also an integer, stands the conjecture I could potentially add A and B, subtract A and B, multiply A and B, divide A and B, and get out an output C, which is also an integer. So an arithmetic operator has those basic add, subtract, divide, and multiply. Okay, so there's your basic arithmetic operators. The plus, it's addition. It adds those two variables together, the two values together. Subtraction, it subtracts the right from the left. Okay, so if I said A minus B, it's not necessarily the same as B minus A. So that is not equivalent. When I'm doing a subtraction, it's the right from the left, just like you would, like 5 minus 3, the answer is 2. It's not equivalent to 3 minus 5. Does that make sense? Multiplication, A times B, and last but not least, very similar to subtraction, A divided by B, the one on the right. Okay, so an arithmetic operator. In addition to arithmetic operators, we've got a whole bunch of relational operators, which is great in combination with those Boolean values and potentially some integers. Okay, so the relational operators are as follows. Okay, so the relational operator equal is A equal to B. It will go ahead and return a Boolean true, which is a 1, same thing as logic, if they are equal to each other. The inequality check is A equal to unequal to B. It will be true if A is unequal. A less than operator, here's one that'll drive you crazy. Less than or equal, what's that thing look like? Looks like a signal assignment, so you got to be aware. You could potentially, where is the signal assignment? Where is the less than or equal to? Again, we're talking about that left to right. Is the A number less than the B number? It's comparing A less than B, and it will output a true Boolean 1 if, say, for example, A is 3 and B is 5, and it doesn't go backwards. So it's left than right. Your greater operator, and then your greater than or equal. And what I'm saying here is these arithmetic operators and relational operators are tremendously powerful in combination with the integers. Okay, you're already thinking here, I can move beyond this clunky definition of a 4-bit parallel adder, which we did at our structural approach. If I could potentially define the number A as an integer, happens to be in this particular example, a 4-bit range, the integer B within that 4-bit range, 0 to 15, and then our carry in value as an integer, and what I could do is potentially create a sum that's an integer, and you guessed it, I mean, that's the purpose of these things here. What would the entity and architecture statement using integer values, integer data types, and these arithmetic operations look like? What would it look like for an adder? What would it look like for a comparator? You find out that it's surprisingly easy, the expressions for adding something up and comparing them. So here's an example where I've defined A as an integer of 0 to 15, B is an integer 0 to 15, C is an integer. In this particular case, it's a 0 or 1, so you're going to have a range 0, 2, 1. And then your sum, what is the sum for a 4-bit adder? It's going to have 5 bits, so that range is possibly 0 to 31 or 31 to 0. The comparator outputs, what those are A is less than B, ALTB, A equals B, A greater than B. What I can define those as Boolean outputs, and my expressions for the sum is simply added up, A plus B plus C. That's my sum output. It's an integer plus an integer plus an integer equals an integer. My true and false checks for those comparator outputs is A less than B, if it's true, output a 1. Is A equal to B? If it's true, output a 1. Is A greater than B? Is it true, output a 1? Tremendous time-saving advantages when you're using different data types and these different additional operators, the arithmetic and relational operators. And ultimately, what is VHDL doing? It's doing a structural approach of combinational logic that can be simulated using the FPGA architecture, where they're actually going ahead and inputting that particular truth table inside a memory device and using those data selectors to go ahead and output the appropriate output for those given inputs. So these are tremendously time-saving data types and additional operators. Okay, so let's move on to our next additional VHDL topics, namely the process statements if case and loop statements.